Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss a very important topic of artificial intelligence, that is adversarial search. We have various type of search techniques, out of which one of the important one is adversarial search. In this particular search technique, we are going to study two important subtopics, that is min-max procedure and alpha-beta pruning. So now let's start with the slides. Adversarial search, first of all, we should be aware about that what is adversarial search. What is adversarial? Adversarial search relates to the competitive environment in which we have two or more players which are actually playing and giving rise to a competitive environment. For example, the game of chess or the tic-tac-toe game, in which one wins and another one loses the game. So we can state that adversarial search is basically a type of game playing in which we can define a game to be as a kind of search problem which has the following elements. First is S0, that is the initial state. Which player has the turn. Action, which returns the set of legal moves in the state S. Result, it's define the result of the action A in the state S. Terminal test, this returns true when the game is over and it returns false otherwise. Utility function, which is a very important function, which defines the final numeric value for the game that ends in a terminal state for a player P. This will be used when we will be discussing the min-max procedure and the alpha-beta pruning, which we will be taking an example afterwards, and we'll be looking at that what is this utility function is actually doing. Let's start with min-max procedure. Min-max procedure is basically an algorithm that is used in game theory to find the optimal move for the player, assuming that your opponent also plays optimally. So in min-max, there are two players. First is the maximizer and second is the minimizer. Maximizer always tries to get the highest score, whereas minimizer will always tries to get the lowest score, so that the minimizer will be doing its function and maximizer will be doing its function. So consider the game tree which we will be looking at to understand that what is the min-max procedure. So in this particular tree, min-max procedure, we have this particular tree. So in this tree, how the min-max procedure basically operates is, we are seeing there are certain values at the leaf nodes. So whenever you will be having a particular game tree, what you have to do is, if you have been given that you have to do the min-max procedure, then you will be given the values at the leaf nodes. That is, all the values at the leaf nodes. And thereafter you have to compute the values. Alright. So for example, in this particular game tree, the values at the leaf nodes, this has been computed by the utility function. Right. So these values will always be pre-computed, given to you beforehand. So what is this? In this game tree, we have root node, we have max player, then min player, then max player. And what is the value of 2 and 3, what is the maximum value of 2 and 3? It is 3, so the value at the max node will be 3. What is the value 5, 9, maximum value in 5 and 9 is 9. So value will be 9 at the max level. Similarly, we will be computing the maximum value from the leaf nodes to reach to the next level. So that's how the min-max procedure operates. Next is alpha-beta pruning. Now, there is some problem with the min-max search strategy. The problem is that to compute the value at the root node, we have to traverse all the nodes. So if we can cut short the processing of that nodes, then that will be time efficient in that case. So we can do this with the help of alpha beta pruning. That is our next example. That is our next problem, right? So we will be discussing alpha beta pruning with the help of this particular example. Now let's see whatever we have studied, that is the min-max procedure and alpha beta pruning, how we can perform in the following game tree. So if suppose this is the game tree, then how we can perform the min-max procedure first. And then we will see that if we do not want to process all the nodes, then how we can prune the edges with the help of alpha beta pruning and still find out the value at the root node. Right, so we'll start with the min-max procedure first. So what is min-max procedure is, let's first label the nodes, that is this is the node which is being taken by the maximizer player, this is the one which is taken by minimizer player, this is again the node which is taken by maximizer player. We have to first label the nodes, right? So now what happens in the min-max procedure? These are the leaf nodes. Leaf nodes are basically, these are the leaf nodes. Leaf nodes are basically being given the value by the utility function which we have seen in the our slides, right? So what will happen in the min-max procedure is, this is the maximizer player, so it will try to find out the maximum value out of the two. So out of 4 and 8, the maximum value is 8. So its value will be 8, right? Now out of 9 and 3, the maximum value is 9, so its value will be 9. Out of 2 and minus 2, it's 2. 9 and minus 1, it's 9. 8 and 4, it's 8. 3, 6 and 5, it's 6. 7 and 1, it's 7. Now this is the minimizer player, it will always try to find out the minimum value. So 8 and 9, the minimum value is 8. 2, 9 and 8, the minimum value is 2. 6 and 7, the minimum value is 6. Now again, this is the maximizer player. It will try to find out the maximum value. So 8, 2 and 6, the maximum value is 8. Okay? So here we have done the min-max procedure. That is the min-max procedure with the help of which we have find out the value at the root node. That is 8. So now we will be performing the second algorithm, that is alpha beta pruning. Alpha beta pruning is basically done to prune certain edges and still finding out the result at the root node. Alright, so alpha beta pruning, how does it process? Alpha beta pruning has got two methods with the help of which we can prune the edges and still find out the value at the root node. The first method is the alpha beta pruning mental mapping method, and the second method is alpha beta pruning with its values. So first we will discuss the alpha beta pruning with the first method. The first method starts from here, from the leaf node. The value here is 4, so this value will get traversed to the max node, that is 4. Now the next node is processed, the value here is 8, so it will check, as it is a maximizer player, so can the value of the node be updated? Yes, 4 is less than 8, so 8 is the maximum value, so its value will be updated to 8. Alright, now this value will get passed on to its root node, that is 8. Now it will come to its second child and tries to find out if it can get value other than 8 or not. So it will go to its second child. Let's label it. If it is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K. Right? So it will go to its second child F and will find out the value. Here it is 9. So its value will update, will go to its parent as 9. Right? Now is this, it is a max node, so it will always try to find out value which is greater than 9, and it is the min node, its value is 8. So it will always find, it will always update its value whenever it will get value less than 8. Less than 8 means 6, 7, 5, 4, 3, and it will always update its value when it get value greater than 9, yani ki 10, 11, 12. So if it gets updated to 10, 11, 12, so can its value will be updated? No, because it wants value less than 8 and it wants value greater than 8, right? So there is no need of processing the next edge. So we will prune this edge. Okay. Now 8 value will get traversed to the root node. This value, now it will always try to find out that whether it can get value by processing its second child or not. So this value will get travel downwards. Okay, that is 8. Now here the value 2 will traverse upwards. Minus 2, 2 and minus 2, the maximum value is 2. So the value will be here is 2. Now it wants value less than 2. It wants value greater than 2. Yani ki the value here is 2 and the value here is 8. Now it wants value greater than 8. Yani ki 9, 10, 11 and it wants value less than 8. So is there any intersection? No. So we will prune this edge. Now we will start from here. Here the value is 3, 6 and 5. What is the maximum value? The maximum value is 6. Alright. So the value will get updated to 6. Now it wants value, it is the minimum node, it wants value less than 6. Less than 6 means 5, 4, 3, 2 and it wants value greater than 8. So greater than 8 means 9, 10, 11. 9, 10, 11 and it will update its value which will always be less than 6. Yani 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So there is no intersection between this and this. So we will prune these edges. Okay. This was the first method with the help of which we can perform alpha beta pruning. The next method is with the help of the alpha beta values. What is this method all about? Alpha beta values method. In this particular method, that is alpha beta value, we have to follow three rules. What are those three rules? These are being described over here. That is, we have to initialize the root node to the value alpha is equal to minus infinity and beta is equal to infinity. Okay, and whenever the value at the max node is updated, it is always will be the alpha value, and whenever the value at the min node is updated, it is always the beta value. Alright, and second rule, whenever the value will travel downwards, it is the same value, that is alpha equal to minus infinity and beta equal to infinity. And whenever the value will travel upwards, the value is forwarded according to the node. So what is this all rules are up to? We'll see in the example. Now let's first initialize the nodes, that is alpha is equal to minus infinity, beta equal to infinity. We have to traverse this value downwards. Alpha is equal to minus infinity, beta is equal to infinity. Alpha is equal to minus infinity, beta is equal to infinity. Okay. And what is the rule is? Rule is that whenever alpha will be greater than beta, whenever alpha will be greater than beta, we will prune the edge. Okay. Alpha equal to minus infinity, beta equal to infinity. So 4 value will get traversed upwards. 4. So this is the max node. I have already told you that value at the max node is alpha. Alpha value will be updated at the max node. So minus infinity will be updated by 4. The next value is 8. So 8 is greater than 4 and it is maximizing player. So 4 will be updated by 8. So alpha will be 8, beta will be infinity. Now alpha equal to 8 and beta equal to infinity will go to the min node. And it is the min node. So remember the third rule, that is whenever the value travel upwards, the value is forwarded according to the node. That is, now alpha equal to 8 and beta is equal to infinity. So it is traversing now upward. So it will be updated according to the node. So alpha beta value is updated at the min node. So beta will be 8 and alpha will be minus infinity. Okay, this value has traveled upwards. So alpha value will not be updated at the min node, it will be the beta value. Beta will be equal to 8. Alright. Now alpha equal to minus infinity and beta equal to 8. This value will travel to the second child to see if there can be any updation. Whenever the value is traversing downwards, it will be the same value. Whenever the value is traversing upwards, it will be the value according to the node. So the 9 value as it is a maximizing player, so 9 alpha value will be updated. So 9 is greater than 8, so this edge will be pruned. Right. Now alpha equal to minus infinity and beta equal to 8. This value will be moving upwards. So according to the node, it is a maximum node. So alpha will be equal to 8 and beta will be equal to infinity. Alright, this value gets to the second node, that is alpha equal to 8 and beta equal to infinity. Now alpha equal to 8 and beta equal to infinity. Alright. So alpha equal to 8 and beta equal to infinity. 2, value 2 is there, it will be travel to the root node 2. So it is a maximum node. So 8 value, alpha equal to 8 is already greater than 2. So it will not be processed, it will be the local value over here. Okay, because 8 alpha equal to 8 is already greater than 2. Alright, out of 2 and minus 2, 2 is greater. So 2 value will be the local value and it will not be updated. Now alpha equal to 8 and beta equal to 2, this local value will get update over here. Now 8 is, alpha is 8 and beta is 2. So 8 is greater than 2. So this node will be pruned. Alright. Now coming to the third child, alpha is equal to 8. Same value will travel downwards, beta equal to infinity. Alright. So this value will get over here, alpha equal to 8 and beta equal to infinity. Out of 3, 6 and 5, what is the maximum value? 6. So 6 value will be the local value because alpha has already got value which is greater than 6. But this local value will be updated by its parent because it is a minimum node. So beta value will get updated to 6, and whenever alpha value is greater than beta, that is 8 is greater than 6, this node will be pruned. Alright. And pruning of this node means this, both the nodes are pruned. So we can see that we have various nodes being pruned and still we are finding out the same value, that is the 8 value at the root node. Thank you so much. This was about alpha beta pruning.